Jack with us to worship.
Are you sure?
He just said my name. Ah! He did not say your name. He said, Maddie, I love you. And don't you know, Perez and Jack, Jesus loves you too, for the Bible tells us so.
Yeah, he's only 3 years old, so.
Papa Bear, can I hold your little cub?
What?
That wasn't a no. Oh, I'm so sorry he spit up on you. No need to apologize. This is a blessing from God.
Okay. Maddie, church is starting in 5 minutes. We still have family coming in and trying to check in.
Excuse me.
Who is this precious child, God?
He's quite a handful, you know.
Well, bricks and mortar make the house, but the laughter of children makes the home.
Gitsy, gitsy,
I will cherish this forever.
How can you do that?
We're just going to put this right over here. Perfect. Here we go.
No, he's tired. We're just going to go home now.
But wait a minute.
Maddie, what is going on? We all time for this.
Oh, I'm fine. I was just tired. Thank you for sharing. Okay. All right, let's get this show on the road. John, you'll go first. Your bird is Sajusti.
Tell us another one, Moses!
Well, there was one time I threw up a rock and got water out of it.
Chat the Lost Chris is the one about the burning bush.
Maybe Moses has some truth to share after all. What about you, ma'am?
Hi, I'm Martha, and I just love to entertain. When I heard that our Lord Jesus was coming to see us, I got so excited. I started cleaning and sweeping, getting everything together. I just really, really wanted to impress him. Problem was, not everyone in my family wanted to impress him. I won't say any names or anything, but it might be spelled M-A-R-Y.
Martha, you need a chill. Jesus said that you were thinking about too many things and that there's only one thing that you need to be worrying about.
Okay, I remember. But I can't exactly remember what that one thing was. He said something about accepting him into your heart, but I don't even know the fireplace.
Accepting him into your heart. Martha, think about it.
That's another family feud. It must be dysfunctional family week. How about you, Captain?
Hi, I'm Noah, and I was tasked with building an ark in preparation for a huge flood.
There's a sucker born every minute.
Please, ma'am, don't interrupt.
Noah, do go on.
Well, the ship had to be big enough to hold two of every animal.
Can you imagine how long it would take to clean that place? Shush,
Martha. Well, in the end, I didn't take a lot of grief from my friends, but overall, there was a flood that saved humanity. All the saints you've come to know are descendants of mine from those on my ship. Every calm soul and nervous Nellie owes something to me for that project.
Wow, Captain, that's really impressive. What about you, ma'am?
Well, I was just visiting the cities from Samaria, just getting some water at the well, and this same Jesus that these ladies speak of, I stopped by and asked for a drink. I gave him a drink, and he said that he had some special water that was even better. I wasn't quite sure what he meant, but I could not wait to tell my husband.
Really?
Okay, my boyfriend. Yes, I was divorced. Everyone is entitled to a mistake.
One mistake?
Okay, I've been married a couple times. Maybe three times? Or four times? Okay, five times! How does this guy know so much? I am interested in this great water that won't allow you to get thirsty again.
Wow, these Bible characters do sure have some wild stories. I do have some questions for this Jesus guy, though.
Yeah, me too. Let's get on with the show. Maybe after all this is over, he'll tell us everything.
Forgive me, Mother Elizabeth. It's been 36 years since my last confession.
36 years since your last confession? Why so long, my son?
I've been a Lutheran pastor. We don't do this shit. Well, see, I'm retiring and I got a lot of things I gotta get off my chest.
I'm listening, my son.
Okay, well, you know that hymn, Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing? You get to that part where you sing, Now I Raise My Ebenezer?
Yes.
I never knew what an Ebenezer was. Dildo.
That's okay, but nobody really knows what an Ebenezer is. That's not a sin.
Sometimes when the other pastor preaches, I play golf in my mind.
Sometimes I look like I'm paying attention, but I'm really thinking of jokes.
decided to call my retirement Armageddon. Because Armageddon out of here. Parallel lines have so much in common, it's a shame they'll never meet. Somebody stole my mood ring. I'm not sure how I feel about that. How many optometrists does it take to change a light bulb? One or two? What's the key to telling a good joke? Timing. God says to an angel, just figured out how to make the earth rotate and create this wonderful exchange of light, 24-hour exchange of light and darkness. And the angel said, wow, what are you going to do now? And God says, call it a day. Forgive me, Mother Elizabeth. Forgive me, audience.
We forgive you.
Thank you. What did he say?
Fly me to the moon.
Get down at the sanctuary.
Yes.
All right. Hold on, Robert.
So enjoy, I introduce to you fountains.
Taking the stress away after getting into a hammock. why are they so difficult to get into?
I don't know. I think they make them out of, so you appreciate it when you're there. I should have a little...
Maybe you can make one of those when you retire.
Get that robot kid back.
He's good.
Thank you, Church Copier, for providing a really cheap way to make a new church director. And for helping people to see the light.
Pastor Tim, are you selling copies of that photo right there?
I am. 8x10 glossy, $14.95.
Maybe I won't buy one then.
You get the picture. Thank you, frankincense and myrrh, for sounding like a law firm in Bethlehem.
Have you been in a head-on donkey collision called frankincense and myrrh?
Have you been in an ox cart hit and run? Call frankincense and myrrh. Have you been in a camel methane gas explosion? Call frankincense and myrrh. Really nice guy. When I really wanted to eat everything anyway. What's your favorite thing at a potluck, huh?
Oh, the potlucks here are so amazing. So many great things, but it's the broccoli salad when, I'm sorry, but when they don't ruin it with the raisins, when you put in craisins. How about yours, Pastor Tim?
I always liked communion wafers and green jello.
I don't remember that at the top of the day.
I don't see it much anymore. I think it was too spicy. Thank you, Martin Luther Bobblehead. Always agreeing with me. When I ask you, is that thought brilliant? Is that really funny? Worried about anything? No. I'm chill, I'm sorry.
I'm still nodding, I'm sorry.
Thank you, Back Row of Churches, for making it possible for so many Lutherans to attend worship. You know, it gets lonely up here.
I bet. I don't even know why we have front rows.
I know. I wish people would just, like, commit to going up there once a year, just to visit. I'd be so lonely. Now, we could have reverse first-class seating. The more expensive seats in the back. Be a great fundraiser.
That would be.
That way, when people are sitting in the spot where you got your season tickets, the ushers could just drag you down the middle aisle. Church on Easter and Christmas. For being the religious equivalent of only flossing 10 minutes before going to the dentist.
My dentist always knows.
think it's the bleeding that gives it. Thank you, Cliffhangers, for...
Of your
kids. I have the best job, I think, in the whole wide world. I am so blessed to be able to work with all of these kids and even the youth that are not involved in Dinner Theater Play. This has just been a really great year. We've been working on this since January, and we put a lot of time and effort into this program. So by being here, you are truly supporting these kids who are the hands and feet of Jesus. We have amazing disciples from Advent that are growing up to do great things in this world. They shine the love of Jesus everywhere they go, at school, in the community, at church, they're involved, they're serving, and we are just blessed to have this amazing group of kids. So let's give them another hand. To give our first ones are our tech crew, our Jeff McGinley, Robert Erste Carlson, Dominic Larson, Cheryl Carlson, and our captain, our team lead, Greg Anderson. And in the 50 adults that have participated, Gary, Linda, Tom, Andy Rowe, Kelly Branch, Harry Mirren, that help support and make this happen. And I'd like to honor and recognize our seniors. We have a really great group of seniors in Dinner Theater this year. And so the first one is Lexi McPherson. Come on. You don't get to see Lexi during the show because she is behind the backstage. And she is running the show back there. She is organizing, timing everything. She is helping everyone be where they're supposed to be. And we could not do this show without her. She started as a server and she came up into this leadership role. She's graduating from Osseo Senior High and heading to U of M Duluth as a pre-business major. And so thank you so much for everything you have done. Senior choir here. She's very involved with the youth. She's gone on mission trips. Just a wonderful soul and spirit. She'll be graduating from Anoka Senior High, and Kira will be going to Moorhead State University and majoring in psychology and social work. So thank you, Kira, for everything. With Vacation Bible School, but really has mentored a lot of the youth as he's been a youth. He leads a lot of our youth music, and he and I and Gracie Onstead have been leading Confirmation, and they're just a wonderful team. Alec is going to be very missed. He also sings in the senior choir and praise team, and just very involved, a great disciple of God, and a man of God. So very proud of Alec. He's graduating from Champlin, and hasn't made his final choice, but he's participated for years in Dinner Theater, and we wish him the best in his future. So, Alec Rowan. Yeah. And also, we can make our music like this. We have a phenomenal job helping us organize music. So, Rachel Johnson. We call her Mom, but she is our servant of creation. She is just truly hearted at caring and conserving for the earth, and keeps us on track with recycling. In fact, for the fountain skit, everybody had to have no disposable water bottles, and that was very specific. So we're always about caring for God's creation, or stewards of His creation, but she's just a wonderful soul. She makes me laugh. And she also teaches and leads yoga here at church. She's been leading yoga on Saturday mornings on her own time and comes here every Saturday. So it's a blessing to have her involved. She'll be attending the University of Minnesota, Twin Cities. So, Rachel Jones. Disciple of Christ, of joy and love, Lily will be graduating from Osteo Senior High, and she is attending University of Minnesota Twin Cities, but has already been accepted and guaranteed into their nursing program, which is unbelievable. So, trips and has been involved with dinner theater for years. So blessings and best wishes to Lily Hamill. Raquel, because we have two Rachels. So Raquel, she is a bundle of energy and joy, little sass on the side, which I get. She is just wonderful. She helps with the music, she's involved with the youth group, and serves on mission trips and works with the kids here, just very kind-hearted. She will be continuing working with children in early childhood and elementary education as she is attending Winona State University in the fall. She's graduating from Champlin Park, involved in theater and just a joy. So, Rachel Raquel. And I'm set by him on the drums. Can't really see him, but he's back there. Again, just another great disciple that Advent has raised. He is wonderful with the drums and percussion. He participates Sunday mornings with the praise team and with the music. Involved in dinner theater and vacation Bible school. And he will be graduating from Osteo Senior High, attending University of Minnesota Twin Cities, in with the civil engineering program there. So just wonderful to have Adam a part of our youth program in dinner theater. Very grateful for your music skills. Thank you, Adam. Computer science, graduating from Osteo Senior High, Luke Bonson. But his friends call him Marty L. from Germany. Robert Carlson, just a wonderful disciple of God, great character, wonderful student, and just has been a joy to have in our youth program here. Very involved with children and dinner theater, and just awesome, just loving everything that he brings to our program here. He will be graduating from Osteo and attending St. John's University in the fall. So blessings to you, Robert Carlson. Abby is everywhere in Advent. She has helped lead and organize families moving forward with our homeless program. She is just everywhere serving and helping, but you will mostly find her Sundays in the nursery, really as the nursery supervisor, so it was really fun to put her in that skit. She just does a great job of caring for the kids here and being involved. And Abby will be continuing working with children, going to Anoka Ramsey College, and then on to St. Cloud State, working with the elementary children at Advent. Continuing working with the kids at Advent, but continuing on with education. So thank you, Abby Mindell. Senior is our ultimate senior. Could we get the ultimate senior?
So, you are our ultimate senior.
so grateful you submitted pictures for the music. It might have not been up last night, so this is a surprise for him. I might have had some helpers who shall remain nameless. But, Pastor Tim has, how do you even know that was my helper? So Pastor Tim is retiring here soon, and so I've been a member here for 20-some years, and you've not only been a pastor, but you've been my supervisor, and you've been a great friend, and you've helped so many of us here in crises or in joy occasions. You were just always there, and you've been here for these kids, and you've been a part of Dinner Theater since the very beginning, the very first Dinner Theater. And so your heart and passion with the kids is very appreciated, and you will be greatly missed. So we love you.
Because you know it's all about you.